Hey, what's up guys? I just wanted to go over our brand new video board model pack. This is probably my favorite pack that we've made so far, and let me go ahead and walk you through it real quick. So here's the video board pack. It comes as a lib4d, so you put that in your content browser, and it's right here, video board pack. And go ahead and change the thumbnail size with this slider, so we have some very nice little thumbnails so you can see exactly what you got going on here. So let me just walk you through a couple models that have some special features. So here's the aperture. Now when you open it, the camera view is going to be wrong. That's because the camera is not activated. Go ahead and go to your scene and check on the camera, and then you'll get the correct camera angle. So this one, you can see it's already pre-animated, and we have this HUD slider up here where you can go ahead and modify stuff. This is keyframed already. So if you go ahead and hit play, you can see everything animates. Now the cool thing is, even the cogs and all these different pieces, like these little blades here, these are all animating using Expresso. So this is a very, very cool rig. Now if you want to animate this yourself, just right click on your HUD here and go to Show Attribute, and it's going to show it right over here. Another way is you can go to the aperture, twirl it down, and this one says Animate User Data. Click on this, and there's a User Data tab on your cloner. Click on that, and you can go ahead and just keyframe this guy. So that's the aperture. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple other ones quick. Here's the broadcast sports open. Go ahead and twirl this down, and let's check on our camera. Now this one, just to make it a little bit more efficient, we put all of the six models into one here. So if you go to the sports model and twirl it down, there's a select your sport here in the user data. So we have our user data tab, and you'll notice that we have all these different options. The one that's zero is the one that it will be. So if we turn that back to one, and let's say we want to do ice hockey, and we toggle that one down to zero. Now we have a hockey puck in all these different areas. It says ice hockey, and we have an icy texture on this ring. So we have all of these models baked into one, and you can toggle through them really quick. There's soccer, there's basketball, tennis, and then we have golf. So that's a really quick way of toggling through all those guys. All right, so let's check out the lift stage. And the lift stage is another one that has some Expresso data. So if you go ahead and look at this, it is animated. You can see that this lift stage has hydraulics, and all of that is set up with Expresso. So again, you have your little deal here, and it is linked to the camera move, but you can go ahead and unlink the camera and put in your own. If you go to show attribute, again, here is the user data slider, which you can keyframe. So that is the lift stage. I think we have one more that has Expresso. Yep, the robot board has Expresso. So this guy, we can go ahead and move it along the X, which moves the board along this bar. And then another thing we can do is rotate the board. And you'll see that not only is the board rotating, but this chain is actually animating, which is pretty cool. And like all of them, just right click, show attribute, and you can actually change stuff in here. So that's the robot board. And I think that's all of them. The rest are pretty self-explanatory. If you're missing any textures, it'll be a HDRI, which we weren't allowed to put in the pack. So go ahead and just replace that HDRI with one of your own, and you will be good to go. The other thing is optical flares, like in this one. I have little optical flare glows on the ceiling. That obviously is not in Cinema, that is in After Effects. So that was really easy. Just put a null there and replace it in After Effects with the optical flare. I have a tutorial on that on my blog. So that's it for the video board pack. There's tons of different models, tons of options. You can just grab these and paste them in your scene. I also have a tutorial on how to put footage on a video board on my blog. Go ahead and check that out. I'll link it up. And it's really, really quick way to throw some footage or a logo onto this video board, put in your 3D scene, and you'll have a great place to display your content. So I hope that this is useful to you. I hope you enjoy this pack. Thanks for checking out thepixellab.net, and we'll talk again next time. Bye, everybody.